Hi, today I am going to discuss about voltage control of single phase inverters. Last class I have discussed 120 degree conduction mode of 3 phase inverter. There we have seen that even harmonics as well as triplet harmonics are absent in the output voltage. But there are other methods also to reduce the harmonics further, but to get better output voltage quality. At the same time, we need to control the output voltage magnitude. So we have to control the width of the switching pulses. Regarding that, today we will discuss. First of all, this voltage control of single phase inverters, why it is required? To cope up with the variations in the input voltage. Suppose we want a constant output voltage. Constant means constant AC output voltage, but if there is variation in the DC input voltage, then by changing the width of the pulses, we can maintain constant AC output voltage. To meet the output voltage and frequency requirements, our output voltage operate based on the transition between switches. Suppose in single phase inverter we are concentrated. Then when 1-2 is on, then 3-4 is off, then 3-4 is on, 1-2 is off. So because of this one, we are getting output voltage frequency. So this switching transition we can control to control the output voltage as well as frequency. That I will discuss as class proceeds. Then to regulate the output voltage of the inverter. As I told you, whatever variation across the input takes place, we want always constant output voltage, that will be your regulated output AC voltage. Sometimes we want different output voltage. Accordingly, we can feed switching pulses across the inverter. Now to control the output voltage as well as frequency, there are different modulation techniques. Basic one, single pulse width modulation. Here only one pulse will be there in half cycle, or between 0 to pi single pulse of output voltage we will get, and from pi to 2 pi second pulse we will get. Then multiple pulse width modulation. In half cycle, here it will be number of pulses, more than one. This is because to reduce the harmonics across the output voltage as well as magnitude of voltage. Then next it is sinusoidal pulse width modulation. It is the most popular in industrial applications. TSD across the output voltage is very less compared to single pulse and multiple pulse width modulation. The first two, single pulse and multiple pulse width modulation, width of the pulse remains same, but in third one, sinusoidal pulse width modulation, the width of the pulse will change and it will provide better output voltage quality. Then modified sinusoidal pulse width modulation, to further improve the output voltage and reduce the harmonics across the output voltage, modified sinusoidal pulse width modulation technique is there. Then phase displacement control. Here output voltage obtained from two inverters are clubbed together to obtain better output voltage quality. Then space vector based pulse width modulation technique. It is one of the most popular. It has various advantages compared to above PWM techniques. In this case, just in 120 degree or 180 degree conduction mode, we have seen that 60 degree mode discussions we have done. Here a reference output voltage is tracked using 6 sectors and each sector will be 60 degree. So we will discuss if time permits. Few more advanced modulation techniques are trapezoidal modulation technique, then staircase, stepped modulation technique, harmonic injection modulation, and delta modulation. Let's start with single pulse width modulation. before starting single pulse width modulation, let's see how the switching pulses are generated. Here you can see that it is a triangular signal, and then there is a DC signal. This triangular signal is known as carrier signal, and this smooth DC signal is known as reference signal. This carrier signal is compared with the DC signal in a comparator, and comparator positive terminal is connected with this carrier signal, and the negative terminal is connected to this reference signal. That indicates that whenever triangular signal is more than the reference signal, then you will get the pulse. You can see during this period this triangle is more than this DC signal, so you are getting this pulse. And when reference signal is more than triangular signal, then you will get zero output pulse. Likewise, here also you can see it is more than this one, then this pulses you are getting. So these pulses we can feed across switch number 1 and 2. Then to obtain switching pulse for switch number 3 and 4, same arrangement is done but with reverse terminal of comparator. That means this reference signal is then connected across positive terminal of the comparator, and this triangular signal is connected to negative terminal of the comparator. That indicates that whenever reference signal is more than this triangular signal, then pulse you will get. You can see during this period this reference signal is more than this triangular signal, so this pulse you are getting. And when carrier signal is more than reference signal, then you are getting zero output pulse. Again, here it is more than this one, so this pulse you are getting. So in this way these pulses are generated and fed to the switches of inverter. So these pulses we can feed across 1 and 2 and these across 3 and 4 of single phase full bridge inverter. Here you can see, so those 1 and 2 pulses here when you will give, then current will flow in this direction. And when 3 and 4 is on, at that time 1 and 2 will be off. You can see here, when 1 and 2 is on, then here this 3 and 4 is off, and when 1 and 2 is off, then 3 and 4 is on. So these pulses current will flow in this direction. When this one is on, these two are off, current will flow like this. So positive and negative output voltage you will get across here. Now here we are discussing single pulse width modulation. So we want to modulate the width of the pulse. Similar arrangement here it is done. Here the carrier signal is like this, and the reference signal is this one. So this is your complete one cycle of reference signal. So from here to here it is pi, and from here to here it is 2 pi. So whenever this reference signal is more than this carrier signal, you will get the pulse. You can see during this period this reference signal is more than this triangular signal, so this pulse you are getting here, this pulse. See here, now during this period or this period and this period, this triangular signal is more than the reference signal, so zero pulses you are getting. So zero. Now here you can see reference signal is more than this triangular magnitude, so this switching pulse we are getting. We can apply these pulses across switch number 1 and 2 and these pulses across switch number 3 and 4. Likewise, we will get output voltage. So you see, when 1 and 2 is on, this pulse you will get, positive output voltage you will get. You can see, when 1 and 2 is on, this positive output voltage you will get, and that is equal to V. And when 3 and 4 is on, then negative output voltage you will get. So we have seen these things in single phase full bridge inverter, but here the pulse width is not 180 degree. Here let's assume the pulse width is delta. Now this pulse width you want to change. Suppose you want to increase this pulse width, then this reference signal is increased. When this reference signal will go upward and it will reach this point, maximum point of this carrier signal, then from 0 to pi you will get the pulse. That means by increasing this reference signal magnitude you can increase the pulse width, or by decreasing this one you can decrease the pulse width. Likewise here also, if you will increase the magnitude of this reference signal, then this pulse width will increase, and if you will decrease this one, then pulse width will decrease. So we can say from here that to control the width of the pulse, we have to control the magnitude of this reference signal. Second point we can observe from here that frequency of this reference signal is equal to frequency of this output voltage. So output voltage frequency, if you want 50 Hz, then 50 Hz reference signal you have to apply. And if you want higher frequency, then you increase the frequency of only reference signal. No need to change this carrier signal. So here in one half cycle only one pulse is present, that's why the name is single pulse width modulation. Let's see the advantage of this method. DC input voltage is V, then AR is the amplitude of reference signal, and AC amplitude of carrier signal. This is your AR, this is the amplitude. Then amplitude of carrier signal is this one, peak amplitude, this one, or this one. Then a new term is there, that is modulation index, that is equal to AR by AC. It is just to indicate that how much is your pulse width. If the peak of the reference signal is equal to peak of the carrier signal, this is the maximum modulation index, and it is equal to 1. Peak of the reference signal is reduced to 0, then that will be 0. Minimum modulation index 0. Modulation index range is between 0 to 1. This we will discuss later. Then to find the RMS output voltage, let's see. Here this is the 90 degree point, pi by 2, and the width of the pulse is delta. So we can split it as pi by 2 plus delta by 2 this point, and this is pi by 2 minus delta by 2, and same is here. So our output voltage we are getting between pi by 2 minus delta by 2 to pi by 2 plus delta by 2, and during this period it is 0, and here also it is 0. So from 0 to pi our range is pi by 2 minus delta by 2 to pi by 2 plus delta by 2, where we will get output voltage. So we will find RMS value of this one pulse, then multiplied by 2. Let's see. So RMS value is equal to 1 by 2 pi into 2, then integration pi by 2 minus delta by 2 to pi by 2 plus delta by 2, and it is V square d omega t. So you will get V square root of delta by pi. Now let's verify. In case of single phase inverter, this delta was pi. So you just put here, you will get VRMS is equal to V into square root of pi by pi, that means V. So it is exactly same as whatever we have got in single phase full bridge inverter. So from this expression it is clear that by controlling the pulse width you can control the RMS output voltage. And to control the pulse width you have to control the magnitude of this reference signal. Now this output voltage can be expressed in terms of Fourier series, where A0, AN will be equal to 0, And just like single phase full bridge inverter, here you will get instantaneous output voltage equal to n is equal to 135 to infinity 4b by n pi sine of n delta by 2 sine of n omega t. Now from this point n delta by 2, n is equal to 135, suppose n is equal to 3, then it becomes 3 delta by 2. If this 3 delta by 2 is equal to pi, then third harmonic will be eliminated from the output voltage. And when it will be pi, 3 delta by 2 is equal to pi, that means delta must be equal to 120 degrees. Delta is equal to 120 degrees, then third harmonic is removed. You can recall that in 120 degree conduction mode or 180 degree conduction mode, our output voltage deviation was 120 degree and third harmonic was also removed. So from this single phase output voltage, if you want to remove the third harmonic, just make your pulse width 120 degree, third harmonic will be removed. So this is just the basic of single phase single pulse with modulation technique. Based on this one, the other techniques are developed that I will discuss later classes. So I have discussed about single pulse width modulation technique in case of single phase full bridge inverter. Then we have discussed how to generate the switching pulses or transistors. Then we have found out the RMS output voltage and observed that if the reference signal magnitude is controlled, output voltage can be controlled. And to eliminate third harmonic or any other harmonic from the system, pulse width can be arranged accordingly. And this is just the basic of PWM technique. We will see advanced techniques in coming classes. Thank you.